So Rachel said,
now we need to cut the cake into squares or triangles.
And I thought, why not cut the cake into circles or hexagons?
So I was thinking a honeycomb pattern of hexagons like this, and you could make a cut that snakes through them like this. So if I use a knife like that and make a cut, and then flip it around and make another cut, and another cut, see a nice honeycomb pattern coming out. So I'll try to make a knife like that from this strip of stainless steel. The first thing I'm going to do is sharpen one edge of it. Now to get this shape, I need to make 60 degree bends wherever I've drawn lines on here. Now I'd normally do this in a vise, but the vise is just not deep enough for this. A sheet metal break would of course be the ideal tool for this, but I don't have one. So I made this thing, which clamps on here, and I can use that like a break for the strip. Gotta check that I have it at the right angle. I'm checking how wide the actual blade is so I can cut a ledge on either side for it to rest on. Now with the blade inserted in the slot that I just cut, I can mark where the next slot needs to be. I just keep finding more and more uses for my panda router. Now to insert the blade. I hope it fits because I don't think I'll be able to get it back out. The other thing I'd done is I sanded a slight curvature in here so that the knife actually rocks back and forth a little bit, and that allows me to press it down along the whole length, especially if cutting through some tough dough. I was able to press a visible line into the wood along most of it, except for this gap here, but I think it'll be okay for cake. Hmm. I think this knife might be less useless than I thought it would be.